farmers are so important, where the cultivation and the agriculture is so important, this can benefit our farmers and create an ecosystem which can benefit both society and farmers. In USA, more than 28 states have been legalized hemp for the purpose of medicinal and industrial purpose. You will be amazed to know that more than 3 states have been legalized hemp for the purpose of recreational. Move forward. So these were the advantages and benefits of hemp in the concern of environment. But what about the personal level? You will be amazed to know that hemp is so sustainable and has so many features. For example, if I say, if you purchase and use one t-shirt of hemp, then I'll be saying that you save 1300 days of drinking water. If you use a hemp t-shirt over cotton t-shirt, your skin get be protected by UV rays. The hemp fabric is antimicrobial by nature. It is strongest known natural fiber on the planet Earth. Talking about the history, archaeologists have been stated that hemp use has been discovered across approximately 8000 BC over the Middle East, Asia, and China. Hemp has the most tensile strength. It is biodegradable, and also it saves lots of water. Talking about the skin problems, we are all aware of that one of the main causes of skin cancer, breast cancer or genital cancers, is the undergarments or the fabric we use. Our toxins get stuck in the fabric, and which causes irritation, boils, itches to our skin. But the fabric like hemp is the solution to every problem like that. Talking about the market in India, I don't need to speak much about the market, because the population is so vast and the textile industry is so vast in India. Talking about our products, it was a great challenge for us, because the ancient methods of cultivation of hemp are there, because this is not something new. It has been cultivated for years, right? But these processes are not industrially feasible and cannot be scalable at the vast level. So we used recent latest technology and machinery so that we can make this process more scalable, and we can use this vastly to produce clothes. So Canopy is all about hemp and its product. Our motto is sustainability. We want to create sustainability and create products that adds value in your lifestyle. Something that is guilt-free. You don't have guilt for purchasing or using something. Women's crop tops, hoodies, for men's t-shirt, upperwear, our future plans involve undergarments and body care products and cosmetic products. Because, as I already stated, that hemp has more than 25,000 uses, from the roots to the flowers to the seeds, everything can be used for industrial and medicinal purpose. So in a society where hemp or cannabis is considered as a taboo plant or taboo topic, we don't talk about this much. There is not so much awareness about this. So it's time to reveal some positive sides of this crop. So it's the time to reveal some positive sides of this crop and make awareness. There's a one valid point. If I'm talking about the hemp or cannabis and talking about this industrial medicinal purpose, then there's a point why this is banned in India and so much of taboo topic. The reason behind this is the international pressures of UN in 1985 forced us to ban this. But the features and the ability of hemp plant to boost the economy was not been uncovered for much time. As I already stated, Canada, America, China have been cultivating hemp at so vast level, that their economy has been boosting, because this crop can be grown anywhere. This crop requires such a less amount of water, pesticides, chemicals, and anything, roti, kapada, makan, anything can be cultivated by these crops. If we talk about construction sites, if we talk about oil, if we talk about superfood, if we talk about bioplastics, if we talk about biofuels, every sector have the uses. Every possible products can be made through these crops. So this is our first step towards sustainability. We are starting from hemp clothing, and later we'll move on to hemp products like body care, oils, body showers, soaps that are totally organic. In the time, if we see current trends of our society, we eat organic, we cultivate organic crops, we try to search for organic body care shampoos, oils. We always use body organic things. We also want organic drinks. So why don't we wear organic clothes? Why don't we wear organic clothes? Something which not only covers your body, but also adds value to your life, which have some more features. And also, the best part about this is guilt-free. The mask we use, the clothes we wear, these are chemically treated. These have been dyed. These have been treating, and lots of water is wasted in the process. So this is all about cannabis. Our future goals are not only about clothing. We'll expand slowly but firmly. Thank you so much. And lastly, I want to share some of my feelings here right now, because when I entered in the college, we didn't have much ecosystem and environment about startups and entrepreneurship. But right now, I'm witnessing this. This is among the most important moment of my life. And I guess this is not all about me. The coming batches, the coming generation will be inspired so much. And this is not all about hard work of any particular person or cell or club. The support which I got from eCell, from director sir, from my department, from Neeraj sir, from my mentors, everything matters the most. Because I remember, wherever I went about this idea, the teacher I told about this idea, everyone tried to encourage and listen to this. This was the most important thing. This is the most positive thing about this. And I'm sure in future, all of these departments and organizations will work together and create the ecosystem so that we'll encourage more ideas, more innovative ideas in different sectors. Talking about products, this is our website. You can find some of the products. These are hemp products. And I'm glad to say, I can claim about India, not about world. We are the first one to integrate hemp products with wool, hemp fibers with wool. These are some of the products. There are some of the masks. I'll also have some samples of our products. Please have a look. These masks not only protect you from the bacteria and the viruses, but this is also skin friendly, very much breathable. Because talking about the mask, you all have noticed that after some time, you need to take off your mask like this and breathe heavily, because they are suffocating. This is highly breathable. This can protect your skin from UV rays. This is antimicrobial. This is odor free. If you use this mask for 2 days or 3 days, it will not create bad smell. We have also other products. This is a product of wool plus hemp integrated. And we are among the first person to make this kind of product. Some of our product in regulatory and manufacturing process. So lastly, I would like to thank director sir for encouraging a startup and idea. This all this thing wouldn't be possible without Neeraj Jain sir. I'm damn sure, because the person who was more excited than me was Neeraj sir and my mentors. I want to thank Anil sir. I want to thank Thakar sir, because they were the person who helped me from the initial level. We are working on this idea since one and a half years. So thank you so much for that. Also talking about CIDI, I want to thank CIDI for full support. Thank you so much. That is all.
I would now like to invite our honorable professors who have been the backbone of this institute's success to speak a few words on this occasion. Let's give a warm welcome to respected Anil Sharma sir from Industrial Production Engineering Department.
I have to sit here.
Okay. Hello, can I start now? Okay. Good morning to all of you. I'm very glad to have a chair with senior professors and director sir and Thakar sir, Neeraj sir. And a moment of pride for me also, because if your student gets succeed, your success doubled, right? And we and Akshat associated with the HAMT product from last 1.5 years. And I got very ideas from various students. And so to test the student is serious or not, then I always give a tricky material to them that go and work on that. So every time Akshat come with a good idea that I have seen what you have told me. And now I am comfortable with this mechanism and we can go with this mechanism and all that. After two or three meetings, I am pretty sure that we can go further. And we have tried various permutation combinations with the industries also, right from how cloth is manufactured and what are the printing processes and all that. And we have an associate, or we try to go for Bhilwara for that also, because Bhilwara is one of the largest manufacturing sector of North India. And I was having connections over there, so I fix the meeting over there also. But Akshat come with a different idea. To invest in machines, that is a bad idea in today's world. You will succeed or not, the money will go. So to outsourcing is the best part. So he, and one of the part of best part of this startup is he outsources the cloth, but he also engage small villages from Uttarakhand to manufacture his product. So he is increasing employment in villages also. So we had in talk 2-3 days before that shift that manufacturing unit to MP also, because we are having very remote areas in MP also, because MP is in the center of the country. And if you want to ship a cloth to the Bangalore, so from Uttarakhand to Bangalore, it will cost high. So these are the ideas we work out on. And I'm very much happy to be the part of this startup. And God bless Akshat and his team. So he come up with a good idea. His effort from last 1.5 years effort converted into a tangible and valuable product, right? So thank you so much for your invitation. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I would request respected Apoor sir, coordinator of CIDI, to share a few words with us. Apoor sir.
Good afternoon, and it is really wonderful to be present in this launch of CANIBE, from one of our students, Bhaiji. And let me tell you that this is a beginning. All for the whole institute, CIDI, SGS ITS Incubation Forum, Entrepreneurship Cell, Startup Cell is geared up to support it. Why I say it, it is a beginning, because there are several aspects of enterprise creation, and in those aspects, you have to work upon. It was wonderful to hear Professor talking about going to Bhilwara and other places and having a plan to launch in a particular manner. Just to add to that, let me tell you that we are already supporting around 10 incubees in different domains, and we have a pool of mentors also arranged, which is a mix of faculty and largely people from industry. Around 15 areas have been defined, identified. Of course, one is the technology domain, and in which we do not much support. Professors are well capable of handling it, and that part to some extent has been done. But there are 14 other areas also in which we are there, which starts from scaling up, sales, marketing, legal support, and launch of the enterprise, where there are mentors available with SGS ITS Incubation Forum, and those mentors are ready to help the incubees. So therefore, I invite all of you, when I say all, this is one effort from Mr. Bhaiji. Many are hearing online, lot of ESL representatives and our vast pool of students. Invite all of you to join hands with these verticals in the institute to create entrepreneurial ecosystem, where we are offering incubation, pre-incubation, both in physical and virtual mode. And there are people sitting in Indore and in the world to help you, mentor you for creation, launch of enterprises. And just to add to the same thing, there is already a call on 7 thematic area going on, and it is available on the website, where SGS ITS Incubation Forum has invited applications, and the thematic areas are from pharmaceutics to industry 4.0 and agritech, meditech, and all that. That those details are available on the website. So I request you all to think about it, and if you have any plans related to that, please join it. I take this opportunity once again to thank you all and assure you full support and cooperation from CIDI as well as SGS ITS Incubation Forum. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for such an insightful speech. Now, I would request Dr. Girish Thakur, sir, from IP department to enlighten everyone present here.
अनम्यूट करना
नो नो नो
ओके गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन रिस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर प्रोफेसर राकेश सक्सेना हु इज ऑलवेज फुल ऑफ आइडियाज एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स कलीग्स एंड अक्षर टुडे इट रियली गिव्स मी इमेंस प्लेजर टू बिकम ए पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम बिकॉज वी आर विटनेसिंग द फर्स्ट एवर स्टार्टअप being launched by this institute. And obviously now many more will be coming. So this is really a momentous time for all of us, is what I believe. And so far as my part in this particular and this particular venture is that when this boy was brought to me about 1.5 years back by Anil, that sir, he wants to do something in textile, if you have some contacts, please guide him to there so that he can get some valuable inputs. So you know that GSITS has a great reference power. It is not only me, but this institute, which really, you know, puts us at the very forefront of things. So I just referred him to some people who could technically guide him and, you know, take him through with his idea. Because they say that you cannot stop an idea whose time has come. And really, the time had come, I must confess. And what is more, that today we are, from this institute, trying to fulfill the challenges posed by our Prime Minister in form of Startup India, where we have to produce more job creators than job seekers. And this is one of the milestones in that direction. Secondly, we also have our obligations in form of Paris Agreement, where the environmental burden is to be contained by all the countries. And India really is on its path to meet the targets. And in order to achieve the same, this particular venture also will become one of the bricks in the wall. So that also makes me very happy. I wish Akshat a very bright future. He is not belonging to a very affluent family and a metropolitan city. He has a humble background and comes from a small town. And therefore, but he possesses the qualities of hard work, focus, determination and self-belief, which has, you know, been due to which he is here today with all of us. So my best wishes. And I, of course, should not forget to thank Anil sir, Neeraj Jain sir, Apurva Gayavak sir, CIDI Center, and ECEL of this institute. And I wish him all the very best in all the future endeavors. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. If anyone has any queries or doubts, you can ask Mr. Akshat Bhaiji, sir. If you have any queries or doubts, you can type it in the chat box and we'll unmute you. You can also raise your hands if you have any doubts.
We should also affiliate to Amazon, so that this will increase our sales.
Of course, we are doing that. We are also affiliated to Amazon, Amazon India, Amazon Global, and Flipkart also.
I'm feeling bad for the one who's attending.
This was the only one question. Thank you so much. Anyone else?
The bad question.
Yes. Sir, very good question. It is very obvious. So talking about this has many reasons. This is not something of instant thing. The point is, talking about hemp, it has been related to alcohol industry, also medicinal industry. Talking about Ayurveda and talking about marijuana in our Indian culture, in our Vedas and Puran, marijuana was recognized as the penicillin of Indian Ayurveda. That means more than 50% of the Ayurveda jadi bootis and our medicines were made at the base of marijuana oil and other bases of this. So the medical industries and pharmaceutical industries wanted to, I shouldn't speak like this because this is very political. This is very, this creates very international pressure. Also talking about alcohol industry,
I have also stated that four of the US states have been legalized marijuana for recreational purpose. That means you can use it as a drug, right? Talking about it, it was banned in 1985 by the UN and created international pressure. That was because marijuana and hemp was considered as a scheduled drug under synthetic drugs like cocaine or something like that. But today it has been cleared. Lot of debates by UN and other big organizations have been considered this, that this is not as something synthetic. This is very much organic. If we can't use it as a recreational purpose, we can also use it industrially and medicinally worldwide. Also talking about India, I've stated that in 2018, Uttarakhand was the first state which got permission to cultivate hemp. Exact 1 year ago, in 2019 December, Madhya Pradesh government also announced that hemp will also be legalized in Madhya Pradesh for the cultivation of hemp for recreational and medicinal purposes. So this was something misconceptions, confusion between hemp crop and marijuana crop, because these are not same. These are like brothers from a same parent called cannabis, right? And there's a lots of difference, but it was very confusing, and due to lack of technology and awareness, government didn't able to recognize the difference between them. So it is very difficult to control. It is, if you get permission or license to cultivate a hemp crop in Uttarakhand, so people can misuse it, farmers or some peddlers or something like that, because they can cultivate marijuana, something toxic, under the coverings of hemp. So certain rules have been made, organizations are rethinking about this, reconsidering about this, and yes, governments also knows the benefits of this on both environmental level, personal level, and economy. Anyone else? B2B or B2C? B2C, of course. How will you ensure the complete sales of hemp across the country? We are not selling hemp. Hemp is a raw product. We are selling hemp products. And initial level, we'll be merchandising our products over our website and over our social media pages. As sooner or later, we have a roadmap, and after a year or two, we'll be getting our outlets and showrooms for that. How many members in your team? My team is very volatile because I have different departments, branding, sales department, and quality managers, and I don't have very, very big large team right now. I'm also working on this. I'm also overlooking after all the departments, look to expand it in future. Talking about journey, it is a very vast level. I have so many diaries full of my journey. So I can tell you all that in this moment, at this moment, but surely later. How you came up with the idea? Very good question. The idea starts from my college journey. Because as we enter college, we are out of our homes. All of my life and all of my teenage, I have been home in the school with parents. But when we step out of our home, when we go to other city, we need to, we learn so many things. We explore things. We meet new people. So something I have been very, you know, listening about this taboo topic that is called marijuana. I have came across some of the debates considered as marijuana is better than hemp, or marijuana is better than what do we say, alcohol. So these were some of the, you know, debates which were very surprising, which I find very awkward. Okay, how is this possible? The drug like hemp, which always been told us from the beginning, from my childhood, this, keep away from this. This is not, this is something very antisocial. But when I research about this, when I research about this institution, textile industries, and came across the fact that this crop is one of the brightest sight among all the crops. In fact, the research which India have, ancient India have, no other country in the world have been so vastly researched about this crop, but this has been forgotten. So this was all about looking forward to the brighter side of this crop and brighter side of these products. Talking about the funds, I've been funding myself in the initial stage. Looking forward to get some funds or help from the institutions. The rest, it will be fine. Okay. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Akshat sir. Now I would request Dr. Neeraj Kumar Jain sir, Associate Professor and Head of Humanities Department, to share a few words with us.
No. Quite happy and can't express that the first startup of the institute has formally now been launched through the institute. I would like to congratulate the founder Akshat Bhaiji. He has been a good student of mine also. And moreover, I would like to congratulate the two faculty members, especially the Anil Sarmaji and Dr. Thakar sir, who has mentored this first startup. When Akshat has came to me, bringing this unique concept of cannabis through the e-cell, we went through so many rounds of discussions. I went through the idea generation process, design thinking process, and the business model also. We discussed about the team, what they are doing, as Professor Anil Sarma has very clearly mentioned the research what they have made. So it was no doubt the team was also well coordinated and the roles are well defined. The ultimate thing what I found, that it is dealing with a problem which the India is currently facing. Normally, India is a labor intensive country where labor is abundant. Presently, world is facing a problem of global warming. So in such circumstances, we need a product, or we need series of such products. We need the technology which suits to the less emission of carbon also. So I found that this product may capture the attention of the people maybe at later time, but this is a concept which if will attract the mass, then it will create a huge dent in the society, and the venture will definitely be more scalable. So this was really the nice idea. I went to the director of the institute with this idea that when can we do this startup launching ceremony, and director was quite agreed that yes, we should move forward for this kind of ceremonies, and we should motivate the students in this way. Recently, with the due kindness, the deep thinking process, we have launched recently the startup and innovation policy also. The institute is fully ready with the complementary components of the ecosystem. Like we have CD, we have Innovation Council, we have eCell, we have Startup Cell, and we have recently come up with the Innovation and Startup Policy. Very soon, you all of the students, not only this venture, you all of the students will get a format, will be invited on rolling basis through the application, that whatever idea you have, at whatever stage you have, you can come to the institute, just share this. Institute will think of that how can it benefit to you and how can it bring your idea into the reality as soon as possible. And institute will be ready with all of its faculty members, staff, laboratories, definitely will be with you. Thank you. Once again, I congratulate the startup as well as the institute also that it has found such a good opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Neeraj sir. I would now request Dr. Rakesh Saxena sir, the director of SGSITS Indore, to enlighten everyone present here with his words of wisdom.
Dear all who are present here, students, faculty members, I am very happy that after the inauguration of CIDI in 2018, this is the first officially launching of a startup from our institute. I am really very happy for this launching of this startup. Actually, CIDI developed for this purpose only, that it will work in 24/7 mode ecosystem in the institute. And from CIDI, we'll take some startups, some entrepreneurs, some product development, some IPR for Atmanirbhar Bharat and Atmanirbhar Madhya Pradesh from our students, our faculty members, or from outside. So this is very good initiative taken by Akshat Bhaiji. I am really happy with Akshat Bhaiji that he has taken a textile product like cannabis developing here using hemp. So I congratulate Akshat Bhaiji for this startup very nicely. I congratulate eCell also because Mr. Neeraj Jain is very much involved in eCell. And I told him that you create a lot of startups from all our students. Take their idea and generate. So seed started from eCell. It was the seed generated at eCell. And after that, the land preparation and everything is by the institute and our mentor. So Mr. Neeraj Jain, you have done very good job for Akshat Bhaiji cannabis product. I congratulate Mr. Anil Sharma and Professor Thakar also, who has mentored Akshat Bhaiji for his hemp project. And I request all our faculty member also to guide and to motivate our students within no time and with full of enthusiasm and involvement with the students so that they can develop their products very fast in the institutes. We have CIDI and institutes for this purpose only. So I want that some more startup will come looking to this startup launching. I wish that more startup from the institute will come forward and they will join eCell, they will start their work and they will come forward for entrepreneurship and other things. The institute is with you, with all our students, with all faculty members, and for any help from CD or institute, we are here to help you. I assure that whatever is products you are launching, that will be kept in our institute store also. We are launching institute store recently, where a lot of things will be sold there. So we'll put your products in institute store also so that the every faculty members and all students will take advantage of these products. This is a very good thing that you have given the employment in village also. This is a very good thing. So I congratulate whole team, eCell, our CIDI team, all student volunteers, your supporters also for this launching of this startup. And I wish you a good luck and best wishes for your future. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for such an insightful speech. I, Shelly Bhaiya, on behalf of eCell, extends a hearty vote of thanks to all the guests and participants for their presence and contribution to make this event successful. I extend my thanks to our director, sir, to take out time from his busy schedule and to grace this event. Thank you, sir, for your inspiring and encouraging words. A special thanks to Mr. Anil Sharma, sir, Dr. Girish Thakur, sir, and Apoor, sir, for their kind words. I extend my gratitude to Mr. Neeraj Jain, sir, and CIDI for providing support and guidance to make this event successful. Wholeheartedly, I must thank all the department heads, faculty members, and students of SGS-ITS for their support and participation. I must not forget to thank Akshat Bhaiji, founder of Canibi, and Team eCell for working hard from the last few days to make this event successful. Thank you, everyone, once again for making it a great success. Hoping to see you all soon again. Thank you.
Thank you.